Hello viewer, welcome back to the satellite communication lecture series. This is my fourth lecture. Today we will discuss about the transponders, satellite communication transponders, the receiver transmitter unit used for communication of signals and information are known as transponders. The communications equipment is only a small part of weight and volume of the whole satellite system. It is usually composed of one or more antennas which receive and transmit over wide bandwidth, that microwave frequency range, and a set of transponders that amplify and retransmit the incoming signals. Transponders are of two types: linear or bent pipe transponder. Bent pipe transponder amplifies the received signal and retransmits at different frequency, usually lower frequency. Such transponder always has wide bandwidth, as for example 36 MHz, 54 MHz and 72 MHz. Bent pipe transponders can carry any type of traffic. It can handle voice signal, video signal and data signal. Baseband processing transponders, second category of transponder. This is used only with digital signal that converts the received signal to baseband. Baseband processes it and retransmits. Again, the retransmits it as the digital signal. So these are very basic of the transponders. Now we will discuss about the configuration of the transponders. This figure is visible on the screen, is the simplified earth station receiver. Signal is received in the antenna. Signal from the satellite is received in the receiving antenna of the earth station, and then it is amplified in the low noise environment, and that front end amplifier is called the LNA, low noise amplifier. Then there will be a bandpass filter to allow only specific bandwidth signals. Then there will be the mixture. The configuration is something like the super heterodyne receiver. So in the mixer stage, there will be the local oscillator. The local oscillator signal that is mixed with the received signal through the antenna and produce a IF signal, which again is filtered out by the bandpass filter, and it is amplified by the IF amplifier. So this IF output is this IF output will come out for further amplification. This is the basic configuration of the simplified earth station receiver. The receiver just shown is a single step conversion type receiver. Very frequently there are the requirement of using the double conversion earth station receiver. In this type of earth station receiver, the first down converts the signal to first IF frequency range. It usually falls under 900 to 1400 MHz with 500 MHz bandwidth. The second down conversion in that stage down converter stage, usually the tunable local oscillator is used, and channel selector filter also used to select the wanted transponder signal. In the second IF amplifier, and the center frequency of such IF amplifier is usually 70 MHz. So here is the configuration of the double conversion type earth station receiver. So the signal is received through the antenna from satellite, and then it would be processed through the low noise amplifier, and there will be the band pass filter to reject the other noises except the interested band, beyond the interested band. Then there will be the similar type of mixture as I mentioned earlier. So there will be the local oscillator, and the received signal, it is mixed with the local oscillator and produce a intermediate frequency, which is again passed through a band pass filter having usually the bandwidth something 500 MHz, and then it is amplified through the IF amplifier. The amplified signal is again passed through the band pass filter, tunable channel band pass filter, and this IF amplifier also is tunable. Then it is entering into the second stage of the conversion. There will be a mixture and local oscillator which is tunable. Then it will produce the second IF signal, which again will pass through the band pass filter. Then the filter out component of the signal will be amplified by the second IF amplifier, and there will be the demodulator to get the baseband output. So this is a double conversion type of earth station receiver. It has two mixer stage followed by band pass filter, and the low noise amplifier is amplifying the basic signal initially. Then there will be two different IF amplifier at the exit of the band pass filter of the mixer at two stages, and those are tuned at different frequency, and the bandwidth also is something different. So this is producing the baseband signal, baseband output. This is the basic configuration of the double conversion earth station receiver. Simplified single conversion transponders, band pipe. It is already discussed, band pipe type of transponder. Transponder is a combination of transmitter and receiver, and the transponder which handles very broadband signal and different types of signal, nature of the signal is also different. So this is the schematic diagram of the 6.4 GHz band single conversion type transponder. It is basic, the very basic part of this transponder is the receiver part. So this part is very much common. That is the 6 GHz uplink antenna will be there. It will receive the signal, then it would be amplified by the low noise amplifier. 6 GHz bandpass filter will be there. Then it is down converted to 4 GHz. So there will be the 4 GHz bandpass filter, and this 4 GHz low power amplifier will amplify the signal, and the high power amplifier HPA will be there for the 4 GHz, which will produce larger power, and that will deliver the power signal power to the antenna, 4 gigahertz antenna. So this type of transponder is used in the satellite system. Is usually used in the satellite system, and this is very popular type of 6-4 gigahertz band. So these stages and all the equipments, everything is well matured. Why we have used 6-4 gigahertz? Let us refresh our memory. We sometime discuss about the advantages of 6-4 gigahertz. Here let us refresh. So what are the advantages? In this band there is no absorption by rain. That is the very basic advantage in this band. Less propagation problem, which is less than that at 10 gigahertz at an elevation angle of greater than 5 degree. So this propagation problem in through the ionosphere is much less here. No change of polarization when a wave passes through ionosphere. If there is large polarization, then the signal will be lost. Then the very basic advantage of the 6-4 gigahertz band, the sky noise is very low at 4 gigahertz. That's why this 4 gigahertz frequency is used for the downlinking. And it is possible to build receiving system with lower noise temperature, because the receiving system will be built for the earth station. So it will be very low noise temperature. Cost of equipment is less at 6-4 gigahertz and easily available, as it is used for terrestrial relay link. So this is 6-4 gigahertz system is very much advantageous, but as because this 6-4 gigahertz band is very much crowded and the frequencies are used up mostly, so we are using the higher frequency band. Simplified double conversion transponder bend pipe for 14-11 gigahertz band. This is the KU band. 14 gigahertz is the uplink frequency, 11 gigahertz is the downlink frequency. Here the scheme is more or less same, except double conversion type it is. So this converter will be at two stages in cascade. So the signal is captured by the 4 gigahertz uplink antenna. Then LNA will process the signal, low noise amplifier, and 14 gigahertz band pass filter will be there to take the modulated signals. Then will be the down conversion. Local oscillator will be there, 13 gigahertz local oscillator will be used here. So at the converter output will get only 1 gigahertz signal. So the IF amplifier operating frequency will be 1 gigahertz. So between the down converter and the IF amplifier, there will be the bandpass filter of the pass frequency 1 gigahertz. Then the first stage IF amplification. Amplification, that signal, amplified signal will be injected to the second up converter. Previous one was the down converter, so it brought down the frequency to 1 gigahertz. Now we'll increase the frequency. So this is the 10 gigahertz local oscillator will be used and 1 gigahertz signal is there. So we will get 11 gigahertz signal out from the up converter, and that is passed through 1 gigahertz bandpass filter. So the bandpass filter bandwidth will be 1 gigahertz and it will operate at 11 gigahertz. High power amplifier will take up the signal. Before that, as usual, there will be the solid state low power amplifier and this high power amplifier in cascade. And the high power amplifier, 11 gigahertz high power amplifier, will supply the signal to the downlink antenna, 11 gigahertz downlink antenna. So this is all about the simplified double conversion transponder, bent pipe transponder for 14, 11 gigahertz band. This is the new band, and is with time it is becoming very much popular. Now we will discuss about the simplified earth station receiver, band pass filter, and other. The signal from the satellite will be received by the receiving antenna. Then, as usual, there will be the low noise amplifier, band pass filter, and the mixer local oscillator. Then again, both sides of the mixer, there will be the band pass filter. Second band pass filter, it will be working at the IF frequency. So the IF amplifier will be there. It will amplify the IF signal. Then that would be detected. Signal will be detected and it would be used for several purposes. Satellite television distribution system. This is the television distribution system, scheme of the television distribution system, which usually we all the time utilize. So the left hand side, you will find the uplink earth station, and it is in the KU band, that is the 14, 11 gigahertz band. Program material for studio will be there. In the uplink earth station, it is in the KU band, uplink frequency, and the antenna will be in the KU band matched antenna, this antenna. And the satellite will receive the signal, KU band signal, and it will process the signal, and once again it will retransmit. That signal will be available at very large area of the earth surface. So that cable TV receives all these signals and deliver it to the subscribers. So this is the very simplified scheme of the satellite television distribution system. Two-way personal communication system using L-band. L band is a very low frequency band, it is, and it is used in the low earth orbit satellite, very nearby our satellite, very nearby our surface satellite it is. So there will be the earth station and the KU band uplink and downlink facility will be there both way, and there will be the transponder. It will convert the signal to the multiple L band uplink and downlink beams. So these are the beams lobes. So this satellite telephone is available with the user. So this was basically devised for two-way personal communication. But nowadays, most of the telephone connection, ISD connections are being done through this sort of communication system. So it is KU band downlink and L band downlink type of system. L band downlink type of system will have the frequency low, so that would be very much beneficial for the subscribers. Thank you.